Hello and Assalamualaikum. Good day everyone. Welcome to Massive Open Online Course. I am Ariza from School of Fisheries and Aquaculture Sciences. It is crucial to know the differences between male and female fish in order to start your fish breeding project. In this video, I am going to share with you about the fish reproductive physiology, and we will focus on fish reproductive organ for male and female fish. To begin with, I will show you the outline of this topic. First, type of reproduction. Second, reproductive organ. Third, sex differentiation. And finally, reproductive strategy. At the end of the lecture, you will be able to learn asexual and sexual reproduction types, male and female reproductive organ, primary and secondary sexual characteristic, and finally, types of reproductive strategy. Firstly, types of reproduction. The figure shows the type of reproduction in fish. There are two main types of reproduction, asexual and sexual. Let's start with asexual reproduction. There are only parthenogenesis in asexual reproduction. Interestingly, the larvae produce without fertilization and it produces all female offspring. Then, we have sexual reproduction. It divided into two. First, gonochorism. For gonochorism, sperms develop in male and eggs develop in females separately. Secondly, hermaphrodite. There are two types of sexual hermaphrodites. First is synchronous hermaphrodites. And second is sequential hermaphrodites. They can change from a male to female, potenry, or from female to male, protogene. In order to culture a fish, we need to learn on how to differentiate between male and female fish. Both ovaries, testes, exist in pairs of similar size lying within the coelomic cavity suspended by the dorsal mesentery. Next is on fish sexual maturation. There are two factors for sexual maturation. The first factor is intrinsic and the second factor is extrinsic. Intrinsic is inherited from the fish, while extrinsic is factored from environment. When both factors are favorable, it will trigger sexual maturation and followed by reproduction. Apart from differentiating the sexes of fish, there is sex differentiation too. What is sex differentiation? It can be known as sexual dimorphism, characters that differentiate sex of organism. There are two categories of sex differentiation. First is primary sexual characteristic, and secondly, secondary sexual characteristics. Let's talk about primary sexual characteristic. It is the characteristic that directly involves with the gonad in reproduction processes. For example, ovary and its ducts in female and testes and its duct in males. Next is secondary sexual differentiation. It involves with external characters and there is no direct relation to reproductive organ. The characteristics are size, depend on the species, female is bigger than male and sometimes male is bigger than female. Color depends on the species, female is colorful than male and sometimes male is colorful than female. Fin depends on the species, female is larger or longer than male and sometimes male is larger or longer than female. Pearl organ mostly possessed by male fish. Scale, male has relatively bigger scale. Head structure, bump mostly possessed by male fish. Abdomen, female has relatively bigger abdomen. Genital papillae In some species, the male have elongated and cylindrical genital papillae, while the female have button-shaped genital papillae. Gonopodium, an anophene that is modified into an intromittent organ in males of certain life-bearing fish. Clasper, elongated tubular structures that aid in male chondrichains in copulation. Ovipositor, female of seahorse and closely related pipefishes, have an intromittent organ called ovipositor. And finally, we will learn on reproductive strategy. Fish possesses different methods and strategies to ensure the success of reproduction. Where the strategies are: standardize the time of spawning, where the eggs do not mature all at the same time, but staggered so that the increasing belly size is not too big to sustain egg development. Secondary sexual characteristics develop in line with the primary sexual characteristics. Most fish spawn at certain season enable more than one species to use the same place to breed in 1 year cycle. There are two types of reproductive strategies. First is dun guarders. They do not protect their egg or young after spawning. Pelagic spawners spawn their eggs and leave it scattered in the water column near the surface. Benthic spawners spawn near the bottom of the sea or lake, and eggs can adhere to other eggs, aquatic plant, rock, gravel or sand. Brood hider hides or bury their egg and do not show parental care. The second reproductive strategy is guarders. Guarders protect their eggs and offspring after spawning. Nest builders build structures or cavity to lay and fertilize eggs and protect the embryo. External bearers carry their embryo or young externally until a suitable time and place is found. Internal bearers undergo internal fertilization, and females carry the embryo or young. We are now comes to the end of this topic. As the conclusion, you are now able to differentiate the reproduction types of fish, able to differentiate the reproductive organ between male and female, and understand the primary and secondary sexual characteristic, and finally, to differentiate the types of reproductive strategy. Hope you enjoy the video and see you next time. Bye!